John Boehner's bill got rejected by the Tea Party this week.
Great. Get more specific and write it.
Well, there was that girl in Arkansas who got cheated out of being valedictorian because she was black.
We don't have a black actress in the cast this week.
I'll do it.
You have to be African-American for the whole show.
Sure. I mean, we could do, like, some colorblind cross-gender casting. That's
great. Get more specific and write it.
The NFL lockout is over. We can do something about that.
Wait, what did you say?
Oh, the lockout's over. You haven't heard?
Yes! Ha! Yes! Yes! I am out of here! Woo!
Where are you going, Carl?
Back to work, you ass clown! I was a San Diego Charger last year. I knew this sketch comedy charade would never work. Or stand up.
But you can't leave. We've got two Obama sketches this week. Plus, somebody needs to sweep the stage after the show.
See, no respect. I'm tired of playing Obama. I'm tired of sweeping stages. Okay? Ron calls me Josh half the time. Josh calls me Josh half the time.
I'm sorry, I get confused.
I never liked it here. Marion, I'm tired of playing the drug dealer alien ex-boyfriend in one of your Scientology sketches.
You remind me of Gleep Glorp. I loved him. He was so violent.
Carrie-ann, I've asked you on 5 dates, and you rejected me every time.
Well, now that I know that you're a professional athlete, I'll date you.
Go get in the limo.
Carl, I'm sad to see you go. You made a great peach cobbler for the cast pit.
You've been good to me, George. So has... You've been good to me, George. I'll give you season tickets.
I'm a Steelers fan, ass clown. Can you at least finish this show?
I guess I can do that.
Great.
I'll go get Carrie-ann out of the limo. Carrie-ann, put that crystal down.
Great. All right, next, Teresa.
How about a sketch about Europe?
See, people, this is what I'm talking about. Specific ideas. Write it.
This is the second city this week with actor George Caleodis. Special guest, Teresa Ganzel. Introducing Janel Benisch as the nurse. And sponsored by the U.S. Army. What do you mean you can't find a job? Just join the U.S. Army. Tonight's episode, AAA Bail Bond Rating.
What a week it was. President Obama turns 50 on August the 4th. As a president, Republicans are gift-wrapping a nationwide depression. The United States accused Iran of a secret deal with Al-Qaeda. A top Iranian official replied, "Yeah, the big secret is we both hate you. What's the big deal?" Scientists at the Hong Kong University of Science and Technology have included that time travel is impossible due to the fact that photons cannot travel faster than the speed of light. Scientists here in America immediately disputed the study, citing that most Republicans still live in the 50s. A white buffalo was born in Texas. The same day, a black buffalo was wrongfully executed. Court appearance, Army PFC Nasser Jason Abdul shouted support for Major Nadal Malik Hassan, the four-hood gunman, accused of making bombs and possessing child pornography. Abdul has successfully achieved the lunatic trifecta. There's still no resolution in the debt ceiling battle. It is possible that the president could win big.
Okay, President Obama, this one is for $100 billion.
I gotta say, I'm pretty nervous, Dick.
Well, you got Carol Channing here to help you out.
Oh, President, you are going to be better than Nipsey Russell.
Okay, and let's put 60 seconds on the clock, and it's time to play the pyramid.
And your way, the public eye. John Boehner's house in the middle of the night when he's sleeping.
Things you want to enter.
Yes. To tell the truth. To not name call. To veto John Boehner's bill.
Things you promise.
Yes. A stubborn stain. The Second Amendment. John Boehner's tear ducts.
Things you want to remove.
Glenn Beck, That ass.
Things you want to hit.
Chew your food with your mouth closed. Be kind to others. Fuck John Boehner.
Things your mother told you.
Oh, you blood prison in your mind!
It's also possible that the president could lose Bit.
Barack, I'm getting really worried.
Michelle, just because we haven't come to a settlement on the debt ceiling, nothing is going to change around here. However, I would keep standby on those change of address cards.
It's just both sides made it seem like the August 2nd deadline was going to be the end of the world.
That's just political rhetoric. You need to calm down, relax, order some breakfast, and let's not talk about politics.
Order me an omelet, please.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Joe, what are you doing here?
Well, you know, with this whole default thing, we had to let go of the household staff, so I'm here to cook for you guys.
That is above and beyond what the vice president should do.
Yeah, about that. You see, the country can't afford both a president and a vice president anymore, so I had to step down to your chef.
Sorry to hear about that, Joe.
Oh, don't be. Chef pays more. It's my wife I'm worried about.
But Jill is a doctor.
Yes, she is a doctor of education, but now with the country in default, there's no reason for people to go to school. So she had to take on another career path as well.
Barack, sweetie, Jill Biden is making our beds and calling me mum.
Hello, Governor! I am a cockatoo!
That's great. She took on the English maid persona. She's got a lot of experience from when we role play. Up top.
That's too much.
You know what? I'm going to get Bader on the phone right now, and we are going to make a deal today.
I'm sorry, the number you're calling from has been disconnected.
The phone's been turned off.
Yeah, we couldn't pay the bill. So, but hey, at least your voicemail won't get hacked.
Daddy, Daddy!
What's the matter with you?
There's this strange man on the bed reading me children's stories.
That's just Henry Reed. He's in charge of keeping the children entertained now that the cable's been disconnected. But hey, good news is, at least the NBA's not on, right? High five.
You know what? We are going to go to the Capitol right now, and we are going to talk directly to both houses, and we are going to get this thing fixed. Joe, get the limo.
Sir, actually, you're going to have to walk. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to walk north on H Street, okay? And you're going to hop on the 36 bus. But also, if you want, you can go down to the McPherson Metro Station. Take the orange line. Okay.
We could find ourselves living in a world where there is no compromise, and the Republicans get their way in Congress.
A partisan bill that lowers taxes, makes deep cuts in spending, and does not raise the debt ceiling by a single cent is now the law!
Yeah! Welcome to Earth of a New Nation.
But we don't have any textbooks because of the budget cuts.
But we do have Bibles given to us by our friends on the evangelical right. So, let's turn to Leviticus 18:20. Toby, you can begin.
You shall not lie with a man as you do with a woman. It is an abomination. Abomination.
I hate sex ed.
In our new nation, say goodbye to social programs and hello to fiscal responsibility.
Hi, I lost my job and I need to file for unemployment benefits, please.
Oh, those benefits are no longer available.
What? What am I gonna do?
I don't know, but at least the budget is balanced and the government is out of debt.
Yeah, that makes me feel so much better.
Republicans signed a pledge for no new taxes, but revenue has to come from somewhere.
Fuck me.
Mm-hmm.
What, is that a parking ticket?
Mm-hmm.
$850?
Remember those wars we were fighting in the Middle East? Well, we stopped funding them to balance our budget, and the wars resolved themselves.
Sarge, the Taliban are closing in, and I'm out of ammo!
Ask them if they have any food, I'm hungry.
We surrender! We're hungry!
Lies and disinformation are still the keys for the right to stay in power and to keep their jobs.
And that's why I decided to check out the neighborhood.
Well, You promise, Representative Cantor, that if I vote Republican, that I can receive all my Social Security benefits and all my health care bills will be paid by Medicare.
That's right.
Ah, you got my vote.
Just when you thought it was safe to fiscally and socially be conservative.
Fiscal policies have disproportionately affected the African American and other minority communities. It's been 6 months and still nobody is hiring.
I got a job for you. You could be my motherfucking slave.
Auditions for amateur clowns in Anaheim this Tuesday. Meanwhile, professional clowns will work all weekend on the debt ceiling. Al-Qaeda was quick to deny responsibility for the killing spree in Norway. The terror organization said, this guy was a wacky right-wing Christian who killed innocent people. What we do is a totally different thing. The company that makes Blackberries, RIM, is cutting 2,000 jobs. That's right, there aren't enough room jobs to go around. John Wayne Airport is opening a new wine store right inside the terminal. The wine will be sold in 3-ounce bottles and will wind up on a flight to Newark while you're headed to St. Louis. A group of 14 female U.S. senators sent a letter to the King of Saudi Arabia urging him to lift the ban on women driving. The king was so moved by the request that he issued a decree allowing women to drive to the hospital after they've been stoned for talking with a man who is not a family member. Gay marriage is now legal in New York. However, in some cases, the honeymoon is already over.
So you're saying, Your Honor, that because Stephanie and I got married in New York, that we can't get divorced in New York because we don't live here?
That's correct.
But our home state, Florida, won't grant us a divorce because they don't recognize gay marriage.
Oh, I see.
So you're telling me you guys created gay marriage without creating gay divorce?
We didn't think gays would be getting divorced so soon. I guess you guys are stuck in gay marriage limbo.
Oh, Jane, be quick.
That's not funny. That's not funny. We're lesbians. We don't like to laugh.
Well, look, why don't you gals give it another try? I mean, you're playing right into your opponent's hands when they criticize you for taking marriage so cavalierly.
Stephanie and I were together for 14 and a half days. That is like 10 years in heterosexual marriage. Lesbians love harder and faster than straight people. It's a documented medical fact.
See, that would imply there's a biological difference between gay people and straight people, which lends credence to the arguments against you that you're not entitled to the same rights afforded every citizen.
We're both on our period right now. You really want to fuck with us? So you're going to walk over there, and you're going to get your pen, and you're going to draft us up some divorce papers, or Gloria and I here are going to sing Indigo Girls ballads outside of your window all night while you sleep.
I want that song stuck in my head. But you realize I'm legislating from the bench, right?
How long before this is in effect?
It'll be in effect immediately.
What's the rush? Wait. You've met somebody else, haven't you?
Gloria, I was able to get the last U-Haul left on the lot.
Stephanie, I'd like you to meet Amy, my fiancé. When did you two meet? In the lobby when you were in the bathroom. Wait, you're the security guard from the front. I knew you were interested in her because you took so long to frisk my wife.
You mean your ex-wife? Hey, baby, I got an extra 15 minutes on my lunch hour, so we can get married today after all.
All right, here you go, but don't come to me for any more divorces.
I went to the doctor.
All right, okay. All right, you win.
I look to the children.
All right.
No more sit-ups, no more push-ups,
sneak into the bathrooms to jerk off during training camp.
Yeah!
Coming to the strip club, so much better than training camp.
Cheers!
Yeah, cheers, woo! Baby.
Woo! Have you guys tried this free buffet? It is amazing.
Yeah. Hey, you guys, check out my girl shaking her rump roast.
I want all in that.
Yeah.
Oh, the seasoning on this orange chicken. I almost can't it just,
Wide receiver Carl Tart. You guys should start answering your phones.
Oh, yo, it's totally rude to talk on your phone during the performance.
The lockout's over. Coach wants us in full pads tomorrow, 9 a.m.
Hey, Carl.
Hi, Carl.
Go get in the limo.
Fuck!
God damn it, no one's even gotten arrested yet!
Excuse me, yeah, can I get this to go?
We now go to our correspondent in Europe covering the tragedy in Norway. Let's hope she can give us a little bit of extra information for the Americans who are not familiar with that part of Europe.
And now to Sally in Copenhagen. Sally?
Oh, hi, Brad. Actually, I'm in Oslo, the capital of the Netherlands.
Isn't the Netherlands in Dutchland?
And isn't Dutchland Germany?
Lydia, Brad, I'm being told now that Oslo is in Norway. Norway? I guess we were going the wrong way.
Yes.
So anyway, here I am in Oslo, Norway, and it's been confirmed that 90 people have died in the attacks.
Was there any damage to the Big Ben?
The Big Ben happens to be in London.
How about the Eiffel Tower?
Oh yeah, I checked on that. The Eiffel Tower is in Paris, France.
And Buckingham Palace.
London too.
So Kate Middleton is okay?
Yes. I can confirm with almost absolute certainty that Kate Middleton and Prince William have not been harmed in this unspeakable horror.
Oh, thank God for that.
Yes, okay. Well, Sally, is there any kind of famous landmark, something that might be recognizable for the people at home so they can understand a little more?
I know what you're saying, Brad, and I was checking around because I was hoping that some of the shootings might have happened in an IKEA. But it turns out that A, IKEA is from Sweden, and Sweden's not in Norway.
Oh, there are Vikings in Norway, right? Were any Vikings hurt by the attacks?
Lydia, yes, I checked into that too, and I asked a local woman who, I don't know, I think she was going through grief or something, because she didn't really seem to understand what I was talking about, but she told me that the Vikings have been gone for, she said, over 1,000 years. Now, come on, I think she must be confused, because I see those Vikings all the time on those Capital One commercials.
So, Sally, then there's absolutely no point of reference for us at all.
No, I'm sorry, Brad. There's nothing here that's going to make it real for the people back at home.
Well, I guess we should just call it Boreway then, huh?
Okay. Well, Sally, thanks so much for your report. Now, you've heard of a cat in a tree. You've heard of a cat driving a car. But have you heard of a cat driving a car into a tree? Next up, when we come back.
An 18-year-old woman is accusing former Oregon Representative David Wu of jumping her at a party. Wu's defense? Tiggers don't jump, they bounce. That's what tiggers do best. The wonderful thing about Tigger. Crystal Harris, Hugh Hefner's ex-fiance, said that sex with Hugh lasted like 2 seconds, which is twice as long as Harris's celebrity is expected to last. Just 2 months after tying the knot, the wife of Sarah Palin's son, Track, is 7 months pregnant. The abstinence-only Palins are now the only family in Alaska with more shotgun weddings than shotguns. Daniel Craig and Harrison Ford are starring in the new sci-fi film Cowboys and Aliens. The success of the film will undoubtedly spawn other unlikely pairings, such as shoes and clocks, peanut butter and sand, and Michelle Bachmann and logic. We take you now to this restaurant.
So finally, it's nice to meet you in person.
It's nice to meet you too.
You know, I don't know your name. I only know you by your name on eHarmony, which is Tot Mom 79.
Really? You haven't figured it out yet?
No, why would I? You haven't told me.
It's Casey. Casey Anthony?
Oh my god.
Here we go.
eHarmony matched me with Casey Anthony? What does that say about me?
Look, I can't spend my whole life in hiding.
You know, I have a brother named Casey. I also have another brother named Anthony. Isn't that crazy?
Yeah, that's pretty crazy.
Hi, sorry to interrupt. But some of the other restaurant patrons are pretty disturbed by Miss Anthony's presence here. So on behalf of the management, I'm going to have to ask you guys to leave.
Well, you can tell your management staff that my beautiful date was found not guilty by a jury of her peers, and therefore you have no right by law to refuse service to her.
Very well, sir.
Wow, I wish more people felt the way you did. I wish anybody felt the way you did.
Do you have a picture of your daughter I can see?
No, that would be inappropriate.
Of course, I'm sorry. I just don't have any children. None that I know of. I've always wanted children, though. You know, I don't have children, but instead I have cats. I treat them like my children. Here's a picture of Oscar and Louise. That's them playing in the cat tree. They actually use it. And that's Oscar using the litter box. And then that's Louise. She's using the toilet, because girls are smarter.
You guys ready to order?
I'm going to have the number one, medium well.
Steak and baked potato, very nice.
The same, but instead of the potato, can I have rice?
Yep.
Instead of broccoli, can I have spinach?
Yes.
Instead of bread, may I have a hunk of cheese?
Sure.
Instead of steak, may I have chicken?
Why don't you just order the chicken?
Well, because I really wanted the fish.
Super salad.
Jello?
Anything to drink?
Red wine. Jinx!
Very well.
So this is a picture of Oscar on the ground. That's a picture of Luis on the ground. That's a picture of Oscar in a chair. That's a picture of Luis in a chair. That's a picture of Oscar on a table. That's a picture of Luis on a table.
Oh. Do they stand?
Of course they stand. They're cats. That's a Monopoly board on my table. That's Oscar and Luis on the Monopoly board. Look, they think they're playing. They think they're the kitty in the center. Do you know what a kitty is? It's when you put an amount of cash in the center of the board, and when you go around the board once, you can collect the cash in the center. When your family plays Monopoly, do they play with the kitty?
Actually, I'm pretty estranged from my family.
That's not what I was asking you. I was asking if you play with the kitty.
Yes, we do.
I always think it's better to play Monopoly with the kitty. Yeah, I wish the entire economy was like a Monopoly game. You know, every time you go around and hit pass, you get some kind of bonus. You must really love Monopoly because you can get a get-out-of-jail-free card.
So tell me, did you go to high school in Florida?
I did. Yeah, we didn't have any sports teams because we had a really small school, but we had actually a Monopoly team.
Oh my God! Wow.
Yeah. It was a small class, though. We had about 100 people in my graduating class. Mm-hmm. I'm going to list them all off for you right now. Dario Canichura, Caitlin Howe, Margot Major, Kendall Burnett, Amos Famous, Douglas Black, Kendall Burnett, Margot Major, Caitlin Howe, Chris Huckam.
I'm just going to go check out.
Roddy
Is the parking
Hachel.
Lot this way?
Okay. Darren Smith. Richard Engel, Black Wu, Carl Aiken.
I was just in
wide
the
receiver
parking
Carl
lot.
Tart.
Yeah, you can check out whenever you want,
Jonathan
but you can't
Pringle.
Ever leave.
All right, this is a holdup. Everybody, be calm.
Be calm.
You.
Put all the money in the bank.
I can't.
You can't do that. I have a flintlock gun. Do not make me blow your brains out.
I'm sorry. I really can't. We're out of cash.
Cash? What the hell are you talking about?
I mean, ever since Congress failed to raise the debt ceiling and defaulted on their loans, we've been waiting for our cash. The government keeps sending us IOUs. You want IOUs?
I need cash. Now.
Well, usually I would normally suggest hitting the ATM, but it's been dry for days.
You, what about you? You have a purse. Do you have some money in it?
Nope. Ask her.
You, give me your wallet. There's no cash in here.
Well, I was here to try to get a loan for a small business. See, I want to open a jewelry store.
Well, at least you have credit cards.
They're maxed out.
Give me a bracelet.
Okay, but it's fake.
What? Fake?
Well, it's not really fake. It's plastic. See, it was a prototype for my jewelry store. But I could give you an IOU, and then you could redeem it if my jewelry store ever opens.
What don't you understand about I need cash now?
Well, if you don't mind me asking, why do you need the cash?
My insurance company dropped me today because I had too many prescriptions. Oh. I need my medication.
Oh, that's why you're so cranky.
Oh, hey, there is a place you can get free health care, prison. A guy robbed us last week just so he could get arrested and then see the prison doctor.
Freeze! Freeze! Get down on the ground! Get down on the ground! Put the weapon down!
I confess, I robbed this bank. Please take me to jail.
Okay, good. All right, I can't take you to jail. I'm sorry. A bunch of people, they found out about this loophole. They can get free medical insurance if they go to prison. So in the last 2 weeks, the prison has totally become full, but I can give you an IOU.
What? What if I shoot that woman in the face?
Yeah, that would work, but you gave me your weapon, so another time.
Oh, shit.
The skeleton of a man that disappeared 27 years ago was found in a bank chimney in Louisiana. It's not known for certain, but preliminary tests indicate the man died as a result of the flu. There was a Glee panel at Comic-Con this weekend. It marked the first time that Comic-Con attendees ever said, "Get those nerds out of here." An Arizona woman has been charged with child abuse after going shopping, leaving her 2-year-old daughter locked in a car on a 106-degree day. The judge rejected her initial plea of temporary insanity, instead pronouncing her permanently dumb as fuck. We take you now to this camp.
Hey there, little Timmy.
Oh, hey there, Mr. Bachman.
Why looking so glum? Why the sad faces?
I don't know, Mr. Bachman. I'm just so bored. There's nothing to do. I mean, Glee's in reruns. The Elton John tour is come and gone. And Halloween isn't for another 3 months.
Yeah. You know what, Timmy? It sounds like you have a case of the summer doldrums.
The what?
The summer doldrums. It often happens. It often happens. It sounds like something maybe you need to take care of yourself, do something wholesome and fun. Go out and go ahead and play with no shirts on. Or if you want, you can go ahead and you can kneel down right here and pray with no shirts on either.
What do you mean, Dr. Bachman?
Oh, you don't have to call me Dr. Bachman. We're friends now. You can call me Marcus. Okay?
Okay.
So, all right. Okay, so let me tell you what it is that I have here. Okay?
Okay.
I have my own little camp, and it's for young, strapping men, okay? With nice buns and nice asses, like you.
I don't know, Dr. Bachman. I mean, camp, that seems like a thing for kids.
Oh, no, this isn't for kids. This is for men. This is for supermen. So you know what it is? It's my Pray the Gay Away camp.
Pray the Gay Away? What does that mean?
Yeah, well, there's some people, they don't want to be loved by God. They want to love each other instead. And we call them the gays. Okay, so let me just maybe make a little example for you, okay? So say you're just standing there, you know, looking like you do and just being you, right? And someone, well, they might just come up to you.
Oh,
No. No, that wouldn't. Now that wouldn't feel very good, would it, Tim?
No. No, it would not.
That'd be strange, huh?
Yes, that would be, yes.
Yeah, well, you know what? There's lots of young Christian men, strapping Christian men at my camp who could do the same thing, who will, and will help fill your dirty little mouth with prayers. Yes, and will help you go all up and down and go down on that Bible. Yes, and you'll be learning, you'll be pulling it out.
Okay, well, Dr. Bachman, wait, I can read the Bible anytime I want. But what's so special about Pray the Gay Away?
Well, maybe it's something that I should show you from some of my friends. Boys!
Hi, I'm Billy. I'm here for archery.
I'm Bobby. I like to lift weights.
Hey, I'm Johnny.
And what do you do, Johnny?
I'm in charge of the spankings. That's so I can train myself to discipline my adopted Christian children when I'm older, like Mr. Marcus over there.
God, Marcus, this sounds fantastic.
That's what I wanted to hear. Okay, let's slather you boys up. Come on.
I'm bored.
These toys suck.
I know, let's play Monopoly.
Yeah! New for 2011, Parker Brothers introduces Monopoly, the Debt Crisis Edition.
Okay, first the banks give everybody $1,500.
Hold on a second there, champ. You forgot about the debt ceiling.
What?
The debt ceiling, silly! You can't take that much money. America can't borrow enough to pay you off.
But that doesn't make any sense.
You're damn right it doesn't. But it's good fiscal policy.
But we still get $200 every time we pass go.
Yay!
Like hell you can. Wasteful government programs have to go. We're not paying people to move past arbitrary locations.
Fine, can we just get started and we'll figure it out? I want to buy some land and build some houses.
Blow it out your ass!
What?
Loans for overspending like that got us in this mess. Find some subsidized housing on Baldy Avenue.
The purple ones don't stock!
That's what you get for spending outside your means, you greedy little shit.
Oh!
Oh, I don't want to play anymore.
Too bad! These issues aren't going away on their own. That's why Monopoly, the Debt Crisis Edition, also includes the company companion game, Fiscal Debate in 2010.
Hi!
Hi!
Welcome to Pandora Express!
Wow, is this the company that gives musical suggestions based on song suggestions that are entered by a user?
Yes, but the user, in this case, the eater, provides us with feedback based on suggestions that our service has provided them with, and we take that into account for future selections.
Well, it's gotta be Panda Express.
Can I offer you our combo meal? It's one sandwich, this our choice of sides, and a drink.
I'd like a burrito.
Okay. Here's a taco. We've added a little bit of extra salsa.
I ordered a burrito.
We think you'll like the taco, because like a burrito, it has Mexican roots and features a tortilla covering. If you don't like it, just let us know, and we'll get something different for you.
Well, yeah, it's good, but it's not exactly what I wanted. Maybe it's too much salsa.
Of course. Here's a Mediterranean wrap.
No, thanks.
You don't like rap. Just let us know stuff like that.
Hey, maybe that guy back there. Do you have a burrito? That guy right here, he's eating a burrito. I just want one of those.
We here at Panda Express have been studying people like you for a long time, so we actually know what you want to eat better than you do. When that gentleman came in, he was in the mood for Belgian waffles, so we served him up a mango tart. But because he's allergic to mangoes, we had to substitute some yummy lettuce wraps. Don't you love those? You build them yourself, and they're fun. Well, he's a vegetarian, and we only have a beef option. So the next choice was potato empanadas, and he loved the concept, but he's trying to stay away from greasy food, so we said burrito, and he loves it. Look how happy he is.
Yeah, he looks happy.
So if I order a Belgian waffle, I'll get a burrito?
I'm sorry, sir, that you've already indicated that you don't like tacos, and those are in the same category as the yummy lettuce wraps, so you'll probably end up with a grilled cheese if you want something handheld.
Okay. You know what? No grilled cheese. I don't want any of that crap. Why don't you stop giving suggestions to me in the first place? In fact, why don't you stop speaking? Okay, because I know what I like. And what I like is burritos.
One grilled cheese coming
no.
up.
No!
Here you go, sir. One grilled cheese.
Great, can I get a nice tea with that, please?
One vanilla latte coming right up.
Microsoft apologized Monday for its tweet about Amy Winehouse that encouraged mourners to buy her music from Microsoft's store. Said a spokesman, "We are truly sorry if we offended anyone with our great prices and tremendous selection of Amy Winehouse's top hits that are conveniently available from your desktop only 147 days before Christmas."
What do you think you're doing?
What? Who are you?
He's Jim Morrison.
And he asked you a question.
Oh my God, Kurt Cobain, Janis Joplin, I love you.
We're sure you do. Now please answer the question.
Jimi Hendrix? Wait a minute. Kurt Cobain,
Jim Morrison, Janis Joplin, you guys are...
That's right.
The 27 Club!
All the greatest musicians who die young, they die at the age of 27. And they become...
Now I'm gonna ask you one more time. What the hell do you think you're doing?
I was just gonna lie down for a bit.
It looks like you were about to die.
Oh no, I always look like this.
You can't die.
Yeah, at least not right now.
What do you mean? Why not? Because you're 27. So if you die now, you're gonna become a member of the
27 Club.
And we just can't have that.
And why not?
Because frankly, you're not big enough. We just can't let anybody in.
Hey, what the hell? You guys didn't say you were doing this now.
Who are you?
I'm Brian Jones.
Who?
See, this is what we're talking about. Because he died when he was 27, so Brian is considered in...
27 Club. I was in Rolling Stones. That is an epic band.
Yeah, but you're not Keith Richards or Mick Jagger.
I've started the bloody band.
You're nothing. Punk-ass bitch. See, baby, we need you to die next year. Or maybe, when you're 33, you can join the 33 Club.
Who's in the 33 Club?
Jesus.
The 33 Club!
So what do you say? Hold on for a couple another years. For us?
Well, I think I'm good enough to be in the 27 Club. What? My album Back to Black won 5 Grammys.
Yeah, that's a really great album. Oh, shut up, Cobain. You're even lucky to be in this club. Grunge rock, bitch, please.
Screw you, Morrison. You can't even play an instrument.
Yeah, that's true, man. Yeah, but neither does Janis.
I play guitar.
Acoustic.
Guys, look. If you don't want me to be in your club...
Look, kid, we think you're great. Yeah, Rehab was a really good song. Oh, Jesus, Kurt, why don't you just blow her? Swear to God, Morrison, I'm gonna shove that whiskey bottle right up your ass.
All right!
We just don't think you're ready yet, darling.
Yeah, take a few more years to let yourself grow. We think you're gonna be huge.
Really?
Sure.
Hell yeah.
So why don't you go in the bathroom, throw up any pills or booze you've taken, start fresh tomorrow.
All right, guys.
All right, let me just play with you guys. What?
She all right?
I don't think so.
Oh.
All right, Brian. Now, remember, the school parking lot is no place to sell bootleg DVDs.
Yes, Principal Thompson.
Save for eBay, okay?
Yes, Principal.
Please, call me Principal Thompson, all right? I mean, remember, the last three letters in Principal spell pal. Okay.
Miss Principal, there's an African-American student to see you.
Oh, Kimberly Wimberly. Send her on in. Hi, Kimberly. Go ahead and take a seat. Now, Kimberly, I like to think that I'm pretty hip to what the kids, you know, are into and doing. So,
okay.
I was thinking for this year I would change some things up. And your graduating class would have two valedictorians.
But why? I have the highest GPA.
Yes, but John Johnson is right behind you.
But his GPA isn't higher than mine, so I don't understand.
Yes, but he took on one more class this semester than you, so it kind of evens out.
Even though he took an extra class, he still doesn't have the highest GPA.
Yes, but you see, the rule book states that you have to be enrolled for two full semesters in order to be eligible. So, you know, and with your medical problems last year.
Are you talking about when I had my baby?
You know, when your leave of absence.
You know, even with my leave of absence, I still have the highest GPA, and I'm still not valedictorian?
No, you are valedictorian, just right alongside John Johnson. Isn't it great to know that you two are the smartest kids in your class?
Oh yeah, it's great to know that I'm gonna be sharing the podium with Star Trek Johnson, who wants to deliver his speech in Klingon.
Now, I didn't know that.
You know what? If I wasn't eligible for class rank, why am I even valedictorian?
Whoa, Kimberly, uncle. Okay, don't shoot the messengers. All right? I mean, I don't make the rules. I just enforce them. Okay? And really, there's only 2 days till graduation. That's not enough time to change anything. So let's just have a super day.
You know what? I'm not going to have a super day. I need to go write my commencement speech. It's titled, "My Principal is a Racist."
The kids really dig me.
Scouts, as we sit here under the clear Alaskan sky, we will learn to navigate with the stars.
Why don't we just use the GPS on my iPhone?
To be true outdoorsmen, we shall learn to navigate the way our ancestors did before the GPS. It is the true scout way.
Yeah, Les, you dumb shit.
Shut it, Victor.
Fritz, do you know how to make a fire with rubbing two sticks together?
But of course I do. The scout way.
Well, why don't you get those sticks and show the other lads?
I have a lighter.
Les, you're killing me. Oh my god, Fritz is being eaten by a bear.
Everybody calm down. This is the scout way.
Okay.
I have a gun.
Oh yes, that's the scout way. Be prepared. Give me that. Okay, Victor.
What?
Go see if that bear is still hungry. Go see if he's hungry. Go, Victor.
Welcome back, Tropes. Welcome back. Good to see so many beautiful faces after what was a terrible lockout, but I do believe we are prepared to put that behind us.
Yes.
Excellent. So, gentlemen, what is most important here is that we understand where we're all coming from. That we all care about one thing. We all care about this game. It's in our hearts. And if anyone here is here for any other reason than the love of this game, well, then there's the door. Whoa, okay, wait, take a seat. I'm sorry. Yeah, take a seat. I just, getting ahead of myself. Of course you're here for various reasons. Oh, you got your sense of superiority, the money, the fame, the women. Venus envy. I think what's important here is in order to make this Super Bowl, Dickens, Thompson, wide receiver Carl Tart, we gotta make sure we put the interest of the team before the interests of ourselves. And if anyone here has a problem with that, of putting the team first, well then, there's the door. Okay, I'm sorry, please take a seat. I am being totally unclear about this. I don't know what that is. Goodness gracious. Okay, you know, you take that time for yourselves. I know you got your endorsement deals and whatnot. Your families. You got 20 kids, it's fine. Now, what you have to understand, though, is I'm just asking for like 30 minutes on the treadmill. No big deal. We just run off the day. No, okay. What? Okay, no practice, no training. No practice, no training. I swear to God, just take a seat. Oy. All right. Seeing that you guys are going to show up to some games, we're going to actually draft up some new plays. Carl. We got an eye formation here that we're gonna be running into. No, no! Oh my god! Come on, you're killing me! Jesus! Okay, I'll hire ringers for each one of you. You don't even have to show up to games. You can watch it on television, huh? No, okay, fine, fine. You wanna go? Then go. I've sacrificed enough. But if you're gonna go, then go, 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 go!
Kim Kardashian's wedding invitation was revealed this week. While the ceremony will be small, there's expected to be a big-ass reception after. A recent study shows that married men who are continually nagged by their wives live longer than married men who are not. I don't believe that. I can't be right.
My mother was right about you. God damn it, I can't believe I wasted all this time with you. Don't you die on me, you son of a bitch! Don't you!
Oh. Now I get it. House Republicans watched a clip from the Ben Affleck film The Town during the debt debate. You know, considering what complete failures they were, if they were watching a Ben Affleck movie, you would have thought it would... Uh-oh, you know what that sound means. It's time for another debt ceiling debate metaphor.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the debt ceiling smackdown. We've got a cage match between raising taxes and cutting programs. First up, on the undercard, weighed at 96 pounds and at the tender age of 88, Medicare Mabel. And her challenger, weighing in at 210 pounds of prime rib, is 65-year-old fat cat Freddy. And Mabel is down and out. God. Next up, weighing in at 30 pounds, he just turned 4 last week, Tommy the Toddler. And his opponent, weighing in at a lean 301 pounds, Hedge Fund Harry.
Nah.
Oh! Tommy went down without a fight. Ouch! Now for the match you've been waiting for. Weighing in at 195 pounds, Speaker of the House, John Boehner! President Obama was scheduled to fight Boehner, but in the last minute switch brings 17-year-old Victor Martin just back from Alaska where he kicked a grizzly bear in the head. Ouch! He'll be heading to college next year, and student loans will be needed. This should be a good fight.
Come here.
Oh! Oh! And the winner is Victor Martin!
No!
And there was a pair on the board!
Speaker John Boehner, you were able to win that round based on the chance intercession of the bear market. Given the mortality of Wall Street, what insight can you offer us?
Oh, I do believe I have some. My name is Boehner. Don't call me Boner. Badass Buckeye with a fly bronze toner. I am the man with the debt ceiling plan, so move out of my way, because I'm rich, white, and tan.
Rich, white, and tan.
Speaker Boehner, your critics say at least you're a hypocrite, and at worst that you play onto political theatrics. How do you respond?
Oh, I know what I'm going to tell you. We raised the ceiling
seven times!
When W was here, $4 trillion in the span of 8 years. Bend over, Democrats, you're about to be my bitch, because you know what I do, I am white, tan, and rich.
White, tan, and rich.
Speaker Boehner, how do you respond by people who...
I steal from big oil and biotech firms. Move over, Obama, I'm going to win this next term. I'm going to be president, God told me that I'm right. I know how I do, because I'm rich, tan, and white.
Rich, tan, and white.
Rich, tan, and white. Rich, white, and tan. Messing with you anyway,